Hey there, Capricorn. Welcome to your reading for the week of July 17th. Let's see what's going on for you. You have this options card. It says, many options are becoming available to you. Opportunities are coming and going without you even realizing it. So yes, pay attention to opportunities. You have this designer card. It says, find a creative strategy to improve your finances. Tune into your own individuality and don't be afraid to be different. Yes. It's kind of weird. I have this like feeling of the universe. It's like, I feel like it's putting ideas in front of you. And it's like, as you say no to one idea by not doing it, I feel like the universe brings another one, and then brings another one, and brings another one. But it's like every single thing that you are thinking about would work. It kind of reminds me of like, sometimes I'll get questions from people. They'll be like, oh, should I write this book or should I start this YouTube channel? And normally my answer would be, well, do both. You want to do both, right? But also, it's like sometimes I think what people don't realize is it doesn't really matter what you do. It just matters that you share your voice, for example. I don't think the universe really cares like what opportunity you take advantage of, whether it's like writing the book or doing the video, right? And I think what's more important is like, what do you feel like you should do? It's like sometimes I think people think like, oh, I should write this book because that's what everybody else does, but maybe you hate writing. And again, I think we should do things out of joy and happiness. So if you're not doing things for the right reasons, then it's not going to work. But again, I kind of have this feeling of like multiple opportunities that the universe is showing you. Maybe you're not taking action on those ideas, but it's like whatever you choose will work. So I kind of feel like you just need to, pick something and make it happen is more or less what this first row is saying, especially if you're getting a lot of ideas that have a lot to do with like your future or creating something new or something like that. I would definitely be careful of like a past liar here. This has come up for you like every single week, right? So, I really feel that a lot of you need to be careful if like someone was like a liar, cheater, stealer or something. You have the magician here with the knight of swords. See, this gives me the vibes of like someone new coming in, and then the second, a new person comes in, the past person shows up, so I would be careful of that block if you have to, or do whatever you got to do. The magician really tells me that you have a lot of hidden talents, gifts, skills and abilities that also you need to use. This could be in work or business, and I feel could make you very successful. You have the Ten of Wands here. Ten of Wands is about being burdened, but Ten of Wands is kind of a card that says you're getting to the end of a long journey. He has been carrying those wands, but those wands are part of his harvest. He planted those wands, and so now he's carrying them so he can release a harvest or so that he can be more successful. And that's what I feel like you need to do here is that you need to realize that you're actually very close to the end. I feel like you're almost at a finish line here, which again is going to be a good thing. You have the King of Cups here. I really feel you need to trust your feelings on something. Like if you feel like you should do something, I would do it. He has very deep emotions. He's sitting in the middle of the ocean. And I really feel for a lot of you, this is kind of like saying you need to realize that you're being guided by your emotions right now. And I would trust those emotions. There's also this boat here, and the boat on the King of Cups actually represents a time where like our great, 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 great ancestors would get on boats and they were just crossing their fingers hoping that they would run into land. So, it's it is kind of an energy of exploring the unknown, going into uncharted territory, doing things you've never done before. And again, I believe that literally that's what the next 20 years is about, with Pluto going into Aquarius, end of the year, beginning of next year, whatever you want to call it, who cares? But, it's very slow moving, right? Do we have to get that technical? I don't think so. I would just work with the energy, plain and simple. And what I would say is that like exploring these new things or trying things you've never tried before, going to new lands, right, is going to lead to a lot of success for you. With the magician, you have the Five of Pentacles. I feel like you're worried about resources here. I don't know. I think it's a very Capricorn thing. Again, I have a million planets. Every planet and its mother is in Capricorn in my chart, right? I'm a Pisces, but I'm basically a Capricorn. So, that's how it works for me. But, I think, a Capricorn sometimes could have $1 billion in the bank and still be worried about money. So I don't know. I kind of get that feeling here. I feel like this is saying like, stop worrying about money. You probably have plenty. And even if you don't, I think you're fine. I also would make sure that you're focusing on your strengths. Again, I was giving the example of like, maybe you feel like you have to write a book or something. That's just an example, but you don't like it. Again, Five of Pentacles says, don't try to be good at things that you're just not good at, right? I think because of school or whatever, I don't know, something makes us feel like we have to be good at like everything, but it's just impossible. It's better to double down on your strengths. And I feel like that's what that is saying. With the Ten of Wands, you have the Nine of Swords. Yeah, this cycle has to come to an end right here. I'm wondering if you can't stop thinking about a person, you know, as well. It's like you're past, for some of you, I feel you are definitely past a person. But like Three of Swords, Seven of Swords, Devil, you know, it's like that looks like a lot of pain to me. So, you know, I'm wondering if someone like really, really hurt you or really did you dirty or really lied. And again, we've been talking about this, I feel, for like months for you. And so I'm wondering if it's been on your mind for like months, you know, or you've been thinking about it for a very long time. And again, I kind of feel like this is saying it needs to come to an end. Again, maybe there was a very deep connection there. They were meant to teach you something. Maybe that's why you feel such a deep connection. But at the same time, I feel it's like time to create some boundaries or move on. With the King of Pentacles, yeah, you have the Seven of Pentacles. Seven of Pentacles says, is the juice worth the squeeze, basically? So, you know, it encourages you to pay attention to where you are investing your time, effort, and energy. And, you know, that's what I would pay attention to here with the Seven of Pentacles is making sure that you're putting your energy into things that grow and remove your energy from things that don't grow. I know it sounds obvious, but literally we go like this up to the Six of Pentacles. Six of Pentacles is my card of planting seeds. It is my card of, you know, putting energy into something. And really, it's like a couple of things. Like if you're trying to grow your business with the Six of Pentacles, for example, it's always a good idea to like try a couple of things and then, or a few things, water them, water those ideas, feed them, fertilize them, give them sunlight, right? Whatever grows, double down on it. Whatever doesn't grow, get rid of it. It's literally how I grew this channel. I just started trying one new thing every single day and every single video. I still do it. I'm sure you can see all the experiments that I constantly do on this channel. Whatever works, I double down on it and I keep doing it. Whatever doesn't work, I stop, right? I know it sounds obvious and simple, and it is just that simple. I just think people don't do it, right? So that's what I would do. Whatever you're trying to grow, doesn't matter. Next, you have in the area of what you need to hear right now, you have this divine timing card that says conditions need to be right, must unfold in its own time. You have this mental health card that says an ongoing level of sadness is making it difficult to get ahead. Yeah, you could be sad about this past situation. It could also be this person as well. Like I would be careful of like, you know, if you're feeling this person's energy or, you know, something along those lines. So I just be careful of that energy. You have the Three of Swords, the Knight of Swords, and the Emperor. See, this gives me the vibes, though, of this person rushing back. I'm wondering, like, I feel like you need to look at your life when you were with this person, if it was a person, and look at it after. I think your life's a lot better, you know? And I feel this person is just a downer, just negative. So I would be careful of negative people. I would also say that this here, you go from Knight of Swords. I'll show you in a minute, but King of Swords, Six of Pentacles here. I would make sure that you don't rush anything in your life. Like don't, and also I would be careful of a pushy energy this week. The Knight of Swords to me is my card of getting a second opinion, but just sometimes I feel he is pushy or, you know, he can kind of represent a feeling like you have been pushed or are being pushed into something. So I would just don't let people push you into things is what I'm trying to say here. You have the Three of Swords. Three of Swords, of course, can represent a separation. And again, I do feel the Three of Swords could also represent forgiveness. Maybe you need to write this person a letter and burn it or whatever. You have the Emperor here. I feel like this is almost the energy the universe wants you to be in. It's like, it's weird because I feel like the, gosh, this button is not working today, but there we go. I feel like the universe is dangling this in front of you. I feel like the universe is like saying, okay, you know, it's time for you to take action on something that is going to be very successful. We want you to move forward, we being the universe. And we see that right here. You go Seven of Swords to the Eight of Wands, which is quick movement. The Seven of Swords can be lying, cheating, stealing, but it can also be a card of tactics. And it's a golden card. I always say, no matter what, golden cards in the tarot are meant to be positive. And the Seven of Swords just says, there might be better ways to do the things that you're doing in life, but you just haven't discovered them yet, or you need to discover them, right? Let's see. With the Three of Swords, you have the Eight of Wands. Yes, I'm telling you, I would be very careful if this person's coming in to talk or communicate. I knew that there was something here about that. So you might need to block this person, or maybe you need to put up boundaries with this person. I also feel once you heal from this heartbreak, or if you are going through a heartbreak, it will amaze you how quickly things start to move forward. With the Knight of Swords, you have the Ten of Wands here. You have the Ten of Wands twice. Again, I would be careful of a past person coming in and bringing burdens. It looks to me like this could be a person who's burdening you. I also wouldn't make any rush decisions. Again, you might not have love. You might not want love in your life. And I don't think this is bad, but I also don't think it's good either. I kind of think it's somewhere in the middle where it's kind of like saying, don't make a rush decision this week, especially I'm getting here if you're thinking about making an expensive purchase or whatever, I don't think the reading is saying don't do it. I think the reading is saying just make do your research, make sure that what you're purchasing you actually need. If you can wait, wait a little bit of time. If you can wait till you're in a better position, then I would wait a little bit. It's like one of those things where I kind of feel this part of the reading right here is encouraging balance or making a balanced decision. I don't know. It's like I have a feeling for some of you that it might be like maybe you want to purchase a car, for example. And I feel this is saying, well, you could right now, and the Ten of Wands is a burden, but it might be one of those things where it's like if you purchased it, it wouldn't be the end of the world, but maybe it would be a little bit of a stretch and it would be more annoying than anything. I hope that makes sense. That's like the feeling I get here, but it's almost as if you were to wait a month, maybe there a better deal comes along and maybe you're making more money. And, you know, because you don't have the extra pressure of getting the car this month, you know, it's like some weird thing like that. I don't know. I don't want to spend too much time on this, but I would just make sure. You know what I'm saying? With the Emperor, you have the Knight of Wands here. Yes, I feel I would be very careful of an inconsistent person or inconsistent energy. I do also feel that this Knight of Wands is encouraging you to be spontaneous. I think it's an amazing time for spontaneous energy, meaning, you know, if you come up with a new way to run your business or you know, a new way to improve your health or whatever it is you're trying to improve, doesn't matter. But if you come up with something new, you know, the Knight of Wands, he doesn't care how he accomplishes a goal. He just cares that he accomplishes it. He's willing to try anything, basically, and find whatever works for him. So he's like an explorer, and I think that would be great energy for you. Next in the area of the unexpected, you have this Goblins card, and you also have this Magic Prayer card. Yeah, it, like some of you might need to like pray for protection or something like that with this energy. I also, you know, especially if you have a person who's like a little goblin, right? Maybe you're missing socks or something like that. Who the hell knows, right? But with that Magic Prayer card, again, I would just ask the universe for protection, especially if things don't seem like they're going in the right direction here. It's almost as if, again, some of you, I do feel you could have a person who's like sending you vibes with this Devil card, even though the Devil is your card and it's showing up in the area of the good stuff. So it's going to be good no matter what. But, you know, again, you might just have a person who's kind of, you know, causing some problems here. So I would definitely be careful of that. You have the King of Swords and the Six of Pentacles here. So Six of Pentacles is a card of balance, equal give and take. And the King of Swords card, knowledge and wisdom. I kind of feel that if you had a weird relationship situation, that it was meant to show you what equal give and take really looks like. I feel it was meant to show you kind of, you know, what that means. So maybe there was, maybe you were breadcrumbed, for example, by a person. And I feel like now the universe is saying like, okay, you see how that felt. Now I feel you need to see the other side, which is like true love, which is a person who really gives. So I don't know. I kind of feel that what could be surprising you is that there's about to be a switch in how people invest in you. With the King of Swords, you know, it's a card of knowledge and wisdom, but I feel you could be attracting a very mature person into your life. You have the Seven of Swords here. I don't know, I have a weird message popping into my head here that, you know, I feel like you need to be more open to something working out in a different way. You know, it's like, I know, like I blame Disney for this, but it's like, you know, in love, maybe you have some crazy, you know, thought on how you're gonna meet the love of your life through, you know, some sort of, you know, Beauty and the Beast meets the Little Mermaid. To put those together, maybe that's how you think you're going to meet the love of your life. But it, I don't know, it might just be a little bit more messy than that. That's what's popping into my head. I feel like it's saying, like, don't try to make something that's not. You know, don't try to hold out for some weird, you know, situation where you meet some dude in CVS and he, you know, wants to tie you up in his basement like 50 Shades of Grey. I'm pretty sure that's how that movie goes, right? A guy meets a girl at CVS, ties her up or something like that. I don't know, right? I didn't watch the movie. I don't care. But what I would say here is that, again, do you really want that? I don't know. It sounds pretty creepy to me. So, you know, what I would say here is, again, be open to things happening in a different way. That's all I'm getting here. You know, he's stealing those swords from an army in the background of the card. And so it just says that he is going to war with them, but just in a different way. He's being tactical. Same thing in business. Again, you might have this idea of like how you're going to accomplish your goals, but there might be a better way. There might be something different. There might be things that you don't know. You have this Two of Cups, which is like a perfect match. So again, there could be love coming in for you. I would say it could be, it's probably someone older than you. I would definitely say it's someone different than your usual type. Every single person has been getting this. I just think we're in a time where we're just attracting a different type of person in general. It just seems like a very collective, you know, every single person I read for basically gets this energy. So, you know, that's what I'll say there. But let's see what's going on here. With the King of Swords, you have the Two of Pentacles. Yes, Two of Pentacles says balance your energy. It's work hard, play hard. Seven of Swords is very similar. Seven of Swords, he has these polka dots on his cloak here. It doesn't want to focus, of course, but polka dots in the tarot, they represent needing to have more fun. So, you know, I definitely feel that energy here where you need to, you're not having enough fun. I feel like you're probably working too much. With the Seven of Swords, you have the Page of Wands. I thought you had the Page of Wands twice for some reason. I guess not, but could be a fire sign coming in for you. Page of Wands, he also is very enthusiastic. And it seems to me like we're in a time of enthusiasm. I think for the rest of our lives, we need to move towards, you know, enthusiasm, excitement, things that make us feel better, things that make us feel different. With the Two of Cups, yes, Ace of Wands, a lot of passion here with a person. You know, this could make you a little nervous as well. This right here, you know, it could move a little quickly. We see that here with the Knight of Swords as well. But also having the Eight of Wands. The Eight of Wands is quick movement, quick success, and you have it twice. But I feel this is a very different situation. You know, it's like a mirrored situation, but the opposite, you know, is what I'm getting. I feel maybe you're a little bit nervous in love because maybe you moved too quickly with a past person, didn't work out. I feel there's something new coming in that's going to move quickly. You know, obviously, if you need to slow down, use your words. I always tell people, like, if it's moving too quickly, tell the person, we're moving too quickly. Let's chill out and slow down. There's nothing wrong with that, right? So use your words. But what I would say is, again, I do think it'll move quickly, but it's like the opposite. It actually, it moves quickly for good reasons, not, you know, just for lust, right? Or something like that. Finally, in the area of the good stuff, you have this card that says, could it be a dragonfly? And you also have this card that says, when birds sing, gratitude. The dragonflies represent illusions. And, you know, if you've ever looked through a dragonfly's wings, it's kind of like shimmery, it's iridescent. And, you know, it kind of, even like some of the totem meanings for dragonflies are that it's like looking through a stained glass window. You know, you're not really seeing things. It's kind of like rose-colored glasses, right? So I feel the universe has taught you a lot of lessons over the years about seeing what things actually are. Maybe you've had a lot of difficult lessons of, you know, buying into something, maybe literally with money, but also could be energetically or with your time, like with a person. And I feel you've had a lot of those lessons where you invested something into something else and it just didn't work or it was an illusion. So I feel the universe has trained you like what to pay attention to. The birds card here, I feel is saying that the universe has taught you to trust your intuition. So now your job moving forward is to continue to trust your intuition, plain and simple. You have the Eight of Wands, the King of Pentacles, and the Devil. Again, doesn't matter what shows up here. It's going to be good no matter what. I feel like the Devil is you. I just feel you're showing up in a very strong connection here. And, you know, I feel there's a lot of abundance and success coming in for you here as well. So, you know, I really like this energy. With the King of Pentacles, you know, a little bit boring is what I'm going to say. King of Pentacles always bores me. I don't think the King of Pentacles is necessarily a bad card. He's just the card of convention. He's like the card of the way things have always been done. And, you know, because of Pluto and Aquarius, well, really at the end of the year, next year, you know, I believe that we need to try new things. I think we need to mix things up and try to be different in, you know, any area of your life, basically, where you want growth. So, you know, again, don't get stuck in convention. Having said that, it could be a Taurus that is coming in for you. I'm pretty sure you showed up in Taurus's reading as well. You have the Eight of Wands, definitely good news coming in for you. It's showing up in the good stuff. But I also feel this has to do with, like, things happening very quickly in your life. Improvement, success. I also feel there could be communication with a person coming in for you as well. So, let's see. With the Eight of Wands, you have the Temperance card, turning one thing into another. I feel you really are starting to believe in your power. Magician to the Temperance. You know, Temperance is, again, a card of alchemy. Like I said, it's turning one thing into another. So I feel like you are kind of, you know, practicing your powers of alchemy, basically. With the King of Pentacles, you have the Four of Wands. Four of Wands is a card of marriage. So there you go. You could be marrying a person. Maybe initially you think this person is boring, but they're not. I don't know. I had that boring word popping into my head. So that's pretty interesting. It might be one of those things where you're just not sure. you know, you're just kind of like, I don't know how I feel about this person. They seem kind of boring, but I feel this person would surprise you. So, you know, again, if you kind of are on the fence about a person, you might want to give them a chance. Again, not telling you what to do. You know, people always leave me comments. They're like, how dare you tell me that I have to date this person? I'm like, do whatever you want. I don't care, right? I'm just saying. The reading is saying, not me. It's the tarot cards are saying that it might be a good idea to give this person a chance. So take it up with the universe. Take it up with God, right? With the devil, you have the justice card, balance, right? I'm definitely encouraging balance. I feel more work and play would be a very, very good idea for you at this time, Capricorn. I feel more play, just plain and simple. I feel that's where you're going to get all your good ideas. I feel like that's where all the, you know, the good stuff is going to come from for you. So there you go. Let's see here, Capricorn. You have this lust card coming up first here. I'm telling you right now, I feel there's a very hot and heavy, lusty, tie me up in the basement type of connection coming in here. Like I said, you know, and again, if you have some weird thing where some dude, rich billionaire, meets you in a CVS or whatever, I don't know what happened in that movie, but like I said, I don't know, it popped into my head. I got to deliver the messages I get. So maybe you're into that sort of thing. I don't know. People pay good money for that, right? So there you go. I'm not here to judge. Next, you have the friendship card. I do feel some of you, this could just start out as friendship because of this bottom row right here. So you might, you know, again, I think there's nothing wrong with taking your time and, you know, getting to know a person. I also feel that it is an amazing time to get benefits from your community. So I encourage people to socialize as much as possible right now for the next 20 years of your life. And, you know, again, someone's always like, well, I'm going to be dead in the next 20 years. Well, rip, number one, but you got to, even if you live another week, I don't care. Go spend some time with your friends. They're going to miss you at the end of the week. So go say goodbye right now, right? The reading is saying it is time for you to socialize. You have this originality card. This is where wealth is, right here. Boom, right here. This is all I would focus on for the rest of my life. And guess what? This is all I focus on right now, right? Is original ideas, new ideas, different ideas. And, you know, here's the thing, is that your ideas don't even have to be original. there's a book called Steal Like an Artist, right? And I recommend you read it here, Capricorn. It's a very short read. But it's not about stealing. It's about, you know, kind of mimicking success and, you know, kind of taking inspiration. There are no original ideas. Again, it's funny. I cannot tell you, not to go on a rant here, but I cannot tell you how many readings I've done where back in the day when I used to do readings where people would be like, I have this invention idea and I want to get it patented. And it's like, whatever their idea is already exists. Like 9 times out of 10, right? And I'm not hating on these people. It's like, I know they get these ideas, they get excited, but it's just funny. It's like, there are no original ideas. So, you know, again, but what I would say is there are different ways that we can approach the ideas. On top of that, again, I personally believe experience is going to be the currency of the future. Having your own experiences is where your success is going to come from, because it's like the only thing the robots can't do, right? They can't have human experience. So again, going, having experiences, that's where it's at. Next, you have the fortune card here. Definitely good fortunes coming in for you. So I see a lot of abundance and success and good fortune coming into your life. I would also focus on the sun. I think everybody needs to focus on the sun right now. Here's the thing about the sun is it shines a light on things we need to pay attention to. So pay attention to your attention. And you might be saying, I always pay attention to my attention. But it's like if you start getting excited about starting a cotton candy factory, you're probably going to say, oh, I can't do that. That's not real. So if you do that, then you're not paying attention to your attention, right? Your attention is drawing you to things for a reason. Doesn't matter how crazy those ideas are. You have this criticism card here. I feel that it could be time for you to accept valid criticism. There could be people who have certain criticisms. I actually kind of feel, it's kind of weird because I feel like you're criticizing yourself, but not in a bad way. You know, it's maybe you're just seeing other points of view, you know, in life, or maybe you're looking at reasons why people left you or you left them or whatever the case may be. I don't know. That's what I get there. Kind of weird. But there you go. I love this. Looks good. So thank you for being here and definitely enjoy your week.